one little point on how far we place our hands out during Wing Chun type defense. Traditional, there are a lot of varieties. Wing Chun fanned out over the centuries. You had different groups, different individuals that said, no, let's do it this way, let's do it this way, and that's why you have so many different subtle variations in the Wing Chun. We actually modified a little bit. Traditional Wing Chun that we were trained was your rear hand is about a thumb's width distance away from your jaw. Your lead arm is out at about the pinky's distance from the elbow. So if you're looking at the elbow to your jaw, this is about where you keep it. And that's how you would work the Wing Chun defense. When I make a point of the elbow being this far away, it's not up in this plane. I don't keep my elbow up here. So this marker where my pinky is on this plane. So we're looking at a vertical orientation. So that means when I actually work this, I'm setting it down here, but about a pinky's distance away from the body. We bring it down to here because we want to, you know, again, if you're looking at efficiency, the more I raise this above shoulder line, the more the muscles have to engage. So I want to keep it down a little bit so that I can bring my elbow into play closer to the body, and I can work a little bit more relaxation on the muscle groups that have to come into play. If I keep it up like this or out too high or too far, what happens is these anterior delts have to contract a lot more for longer periods of time, especially in a long fight, than if you just relax, just set it back down. So that kind of plays into why you would want to bring the elbow, we're looking in again at this line, closer to the body. Our lead hand isn't necessarily always out so far. So if he's in here like this and he's throwing his punch like this, I want to have this closer to home base because I don't want to trust that my body mechanics are going to always be there, that I may get it in the right time at the right place. I want to make sure that if I need to, home base is covered. If this is too far out here, I will end up trying to parry it out here on a full power strike. By the time I actually get this in play on a full power, full speed strike, somebody trying with intent to harm me, I will end up probably doing it about here, and that may miss me. I don't like those odds. I don't like may, maybe, or possibly. I like more of a something that's a little bit more of a certainty, which is if this is closer to home base, it defends anything that comes within this range. And then I'm able to go right back into the Western boxing pretty quick. If he throws a hook on that side, I can go back to cover very quickly. If I'm way out here, let's say I'm out here in a tanso and my hands are way out, and then he comes in and barrels in with a hook, I've got to be that much faster to be able to employ that. And that's not always something that, well, I mean, if you're thinking of a fight, you're fatigued, you've got maybe multiple opponents, that's our mentality. You don't always go for the, well, I can do this, you know, in training in class really well, so I'll be able to do it in the street really well. So you modify the class mechanics to work in the street, and that's what we do. We're problem solvers in that regard. So when this comes out and he's working here, this is there just in case. And if he throws that hook, long hook, short hook, he moves in violently, that sort of thing, this immediately goes to cover because it's got less time to get to cover. It takes far less because I'm only this far away. If I'm out here, now look, I've added another hand length in between there. That's time, that's more muscle contraction, and I've got to try to beat his speed, whatever that may be, and in a street, I don't know. So I train for a variety of opponents in class, a variety of speeds and everything else, so that we can prepare for the street. But in the street, I don't know what his mechanics may be. He may be only really, really good at lunging in with a hard, fast hook from the rear or lead. So I may have to deal with a hook from the lead. He may come in like that, and this tanso all of a sudden it really isn't worth crap, especially if I don't train how we train our tansos. Instead of coming out to here, we go out toward the bicep. Then second hand cover home base is protected because of our more westernized boxing mentality for cover. So that's a little bit of fine tuning on the Wing Chun cover as Core JKD does it.